Is it possible that abstract art can be brightly colored and also interesting to be used in kindergarten classes? Yes, and it's also fun for you and me to paint like Alma Gucci Thomas art. Just after this. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to A Perfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art yourself and the world around you. I'm not the only one who likes her art, so I'll step down for a minute.
And today the old family dining room is a highlight of the public tour and an enduring tribute to modern artists. From the Art Deco tea service, to the woven rug, to the stunning painting by Alma Thomas, who, by the way, is the first African-American woman to have her artwork featured in this home. It's a beautiful space, and it turned out well. And as Mrs. Kennedy put it in that televised tour all those years ago, she said, "This house should always have all of the history of our country in it." And thanks to all of you, today it does.
She talks about this painting. And here you see it on the wall in the old family dining room in the White House. Alma Gucci Thomas' paintings look like this. She lived from 1891 until 1978. First, she worked as a kindergarten teacher. And when she was 30 years, she went to the university to get an art degree, resulting in an art teaching position at the junior high school. She retired in 1960 at age 69 to start her career as an artist, making these large, colorful paintings. Her first exhibition was at age 75, and on this picture at her exhibition in the Whitney Museum, she was 77. Now it's time for the real work. She used pencil lines to help her, and I drew some lines and circles too. I really like her use of color, and I'm aiming at resembling her artwork. Oops, I forgot to press record for the last few lines. Although her artwork is abstract, she is painting things she sees or thinks of. Her artwork has titles like Breeze Rustling Through Fall Flowers, Starry Night and the Astronaut, or Resurrection, one of her paintings in the White House. When I look at her artwork, I see that she varies in light and dark colors. She has clearly studied this thoroughly. To me, this has an effect as if the painted circles are alive, like ripples caused by raindrops in a puddle. I want that effect too. And when you look through your eyelashes for a few seconds, you get a better idea of the light and dark difference in the expanding circles. I mixed different colors, and it's interesting to paint like Alma Thomas. But I also get the feeling that my painting is not at her level. Later on in this video, I will show you the difference and what you can do to improve your artwork when painting like Alma Thomas. I promised to show you what was missing in my painting. This is one of her artworks. When zooming in, you can see how she painted in comparison to my painting. She painted very tight. The brush strokes are close to each other and also very different in form. When you look here, it looks like she painted the colors twice. because this piece has two tones, or she works with not completely mixed colors. Interesting details. And don't forget the size of the paintings. Remember this picture? She clearly didn't make it with a 5 or 10 millimeter brush like I did. This is my reason why I paint like famous artists. Every time there's so much to learn by just making a painting in their style. Like this Kazimir Miljevic and his black square. It looks so simple, but there's so much to discover and learn. Click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video.